see a type of RNA, that is tRNA. tRNA, it is transfer RNA. So tRNA, it will do some function related to some transfer of something from somewhere. So that is tRNA, and it is called adapter molecule. So what is its function? It reads the genetic code on mRNA. We have seen that DNA to mRNA, that is called transcription. So mRNA is formed. Where is this replication and transcription taking place? Inside the nucleus. So mRNA, it is consisting of some bases. So a reading has to be done. Somebody has to read those bases. Somebody has to read those codes so that it is converted into amino acid. And who does that work? tRNA does that work. So tRNA is a small RNA molecule with 75 to 80 nucleotides. There will be 75 to 80 nucleotides in tRNA. Francis Crick postulated the presence of an adapter molecule that would one hand read the code and the other hand would bind to specific amino acids. So that molecule was tRNA. So on one hand, you can see in this diagram, mRNA, this is the mRNA, and here this part, this is anticodon loop. This part is called anticodon loop. It is coding for the code which is present on mRNA. So AGU is present on mRNA. Anticodon loop will be having UCA. So it's anticodon is not coding anything, but just it is having an anticodon, and that will in turn code for the protein. So they act as carriers of amino acid. They play an important role during protein synthesis. So that is the main function of tRNA. That is, it is playing an important role on during protein synthesis. It has a clover leaf like structure. Now tRNA has anticodon loop, as I told you, anticodon loop at one end, and here you can see this is the amino acid acceptor end to which an amino acid binds. So you can see in this diagram, amino acid here, an amino acid is binded at this end. So this is the amino acid acceptor end, and for initiation there is initiator tRNA which will bind to AUG, and that AUG methionine is the protein for AUG. So tRNA will bind to methionine, and that is going to be the initiator tRNA. For stop codons, there are no tRNA. So when tRNA is going to encounter one stop codon, UAA, UGA or UAG, in that case, the termination of the process will take place. So tRNA cannot code for stop codons. So why is tRNA termed as adapter molecule? Because it reads mRNA sequence on the one end and writes amino acid sequence on the other end. So it is doing two functions at the same time. That's why it is called adapter molecule. Why is tRNA called trans? Why adapter molecule? See, you use an adapter, no? So in one hand it is plugged to the socket and the other hand to your device. So that's why two ends it is the charging is going on from one end to the other end. Similarly, this tRNA is also sending the information from mRNA to the amino acid. Why is tRNA called transfer RNA? Because it transfers individual amino acids to the growing polypeptide chain which later form protein. So it is transferring the amino acid. And amino acids, they are the one which is going to form the proteins with the help of polypeptide bond.